Suavemente.
Come on, ladies, come on, ladies. One pound fish.
Come on, ladies, come on, ladies.
I'm in my mum's car. Broom, broom.
Bésame.
Take me away and take away me. Won't you take me away and take away me?
Tell
yeah.
him, Chrissy.
Woo! All right, get off the bus. You never heard that before?
Talk to him, big Chrissy.
That's Mark on the Bus by tell the Beastie
him.
Boys. Anyway.
Chrissy nice. Boy, tell him.
Hey, everybody, we're back with a new episode of the Super Ultimate Audio Visual Experience. Me and Big Bestie are here, joined by three of our other besties.
Yeah.
We have Matt Byrne here, our esteemed guest from La La Land, Hollywood, ooh. A.K.A. Holly Weird, A.K.A. the Left Coast. And then we got Lamizi on the end over there. And then we got Noah to my right.
Hey, what's going on? Thanks for having me again.
Thanks, guys.
We're coming to you guys after a steaming hot Patreon episode that you can check out at patreon.com/tsuave. We had to put that one on the Patreon because Matt Byrne was Islamophobic.
Whoa. You're going to open with that?
And
on the podcast?
And also the...
Please don't open with that.
Matt Byrne, Astaghfirullah, Iblis, Haram.
Oh, you're going to open with that on the podcast?
Oh, they know I'm just kidding.
Oh, okay.
Guys, I'm just
Islamophobic.
I know, I'm just standing up for my woman.
Dude, to be fair, you weren't even here.
Yeah, true. Yeah, that wasn't me.
Yeah, it wasn't you.
That was a character. That was, yeah.
We shouldn't.
That was Ice Rod, dude.
God damn it.
We can't spoil the fun for the listeners.
Yeah, so if you want to know what the
Patreon,
if you want to understand what the fuck is going on,
dude,
right
the first
now,
30 seconds, I'm already.
You could go.
I'm already a villain.
What the fuck is happening?
What's up, what the fuckers? I'm Mark Maron.
Yeah, I'm Mike.
What the fuck is up?
What's up, what the butt fuckers?
Yeah, what the butt fuckers?
What the butt fuckers? Happy Pride.
I fuck my cat. My cat.
I'm here with Donald Soda.
What? Donald Soda. Soda? I don't even know her.
Soda? Donald Soda.
Donald Soda. I'm the Soda. Donald Soda.
Oh, I see. Okay, sorry. Yeah, you playing chess. I'm playing checkers, brother.
Soda.
And Big Chris is playing Chinese checkers. This motherfucker, a lib. Big Chris is a big libby.
Big liberal.
I don't think I am.
I know, I'm just messing with you.
Nah, you left away. Yeah,
big Tricom?
I'm voting. Who am I voting for?
Robert F. Kennedy. I'll speak for him and say Robert F. Kennedy. Jr. Junior Watanabe
Omari? Tell him this.
Junior Watanabe Omafi.
Tell him this. Did he miss? Junior.
Feet?
Wait, Lemaire, scoot in. They can't see you.
Yeah, scoot in, Lemaire.
Ooh.
Lemaire cleared his ear on the Patreon episode. That was pretty nasty. Oh, but I did have a story I wanted to tell you guys that I forgot until right now.
Go ahead.
So I was Ubering home from Matt shows this weekend, which were so fun. Matt recorded his stand-up comedy special. Man, what a treat that was. Oh, Matt's calling me right now. He might want to pick you guys up. Hey, Matt, you're on the Super Ultimate Audio Visual Experience right now.
What's up, dudes?
Nothing. We're just casting.
Can I have your address?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll text it to you.
All right.
The boys will be ready for you.
All right, man.
All right, later. All right. Special. All right, so this now we have to put that in the title with guest Matt McCusker.
Mm-hmm.
Junior Watanabe Omari. Tell him this. Did he miss?
Junior Watanabe
on my feet. Can you hold him over while I text me?
Junior Watanabe on my
feet.
Did you guys listen to that Donda?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
I remember we talked about it.
Yeah. I like Off the Grid.
I like it.
Yeah, the whole thing?
The first time I didn't, but yeah. as I've listened to it more and more, I've come to really like it.
Yeah.
I like all the songs, I think. Or maybe not all, but a lot of them I like.
I did a Kanye test the other day. I listened to Late Registration to see if it holds up. It holds up.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. And then I listened to like one of the newer ones. I listened to like Ye or something. And it's not the same.
Mm-hmm.
Not the same vibe. Nothing,
nothing's as classic as it. All of like Late Registration's classic.
Wait, yeah. Sean, what was your Uber story? You're right.
Oh, you want to get back to the juicy gossip?
Back to the juicy gossip.
The juicy scoop. So I was Ubering home from Matt's comedy special. What a magical evening that was. That's going to be fun when that comes out. And then I was taking an Uber back to my Habibti's house. And my Uber driver was a Chinese man with an accent. Already hilarious. So he's going like, "Hey, what's up, man? You have a lot of drinks tonight?" And I'd be like, "Yeah, I had a couple, yeah." But he's like, "I got to get like you, man. I'm trying to be part." He was like a Chinese guy that wanted to, you know, he was kind of hood with it, you know. So he had like a backward snapback, and he was like, "Man, I'm trying to get like you. I mean, I wish I was drinking tonight." And I was like, "Oh yeah." And then his friend called him, and his friend was a guy from like Delco with the craziest Delco accent, and my Uber driver had the craziest like broken English Chinese accent. Mm. And by the way they were talking, they were like best friends forever, and that was the funniest thing ever to me. And I have 5 minutes of the recorded phone call because he put it on speakerphone, which I guess he was really hood with it when you think about it that way.
You got to put that on page, dude.
Shit, maybe I'll just post the video of me listening to this Chinese guy talking to his friend on the page. But dude, the guy was so crazy. He's like, "Yo, these two 40-year-old ladies are trying to fucking rape me, I think." And then the Chinese guy just kept going, "Man, you crazy white boy, man. Man, you crazy white boy." And he'd be like, "Yo, I'm serious. I had to fucking like run out the fire escape or something. Like, I swear to God." And dude, he was getting so racist too. He was like, "I mean, if I were like a black guy, I probably would have done it. They'd fuck like a hole in the wall." He was being like crazy.
Yeah, fuck a hole driver, in the wall.
The driver's like, "Yeah, I'm trying to get like you getting raped by 240. Yeah.
I wish I was partying. I'm trying like to get you, bro.
I'm trying like, to get like you.
You better wear a condom, you crazy white boy." He just kept saying shit like that.
"Yeah, y'all wearing no condoms?"
He's like, "Yo, I don't even know Ming." I think that was actually his name was like Ming or something. I can look it up.
"Yeah,
actually,
Ming, you're my best friend." Yeah,
dude, they were BFFs. I love you, Ming. They were besties.
Yeah.
"You're wild, Ming. You got to get it together, dude."
"Yeah, there's two things I love, Oxycontin and Ming." Yeah, I love Ming and Oxycontin.
Yo, Ming's my dude.
Yeah, Ming's my dog. Yeah, I could call him anytime something happens to me. Anytime something happens to me, I'm like, "Yo, Ming, I'm in a jam. Yo, what's up?"
Yo, Ming, I'm kind of in a bind right now.
And Ming's like, "Sore my feet." That's crazy.
"Yeah, I stole Oxycontin from my mom's Oxycontin jar. Yo, Ming, help me out. Yo, help me get some Oxys, yo. Yo, Ming, you're my best friend, yo.
Ming, you're my BFF, right? Well, I can tell you anything, right?
Yeah, you can tell me.
I murdered this lady.
Yo, Ming, remember I fucked your sister in second grade? Yo,
yo, Ming, tonight's not about to be chill.
I
committed murder.
Yo, I hope the person to Uber doesn't record this.
Oh, no, his name.
That'd be really bad.
That's so funny. The Chinese guy's name was Yu.
Yo, you.
Yo, these girls, these two like 50-year-old girls, they're like from Peru or something. They're like trying to rape me. That's the kind of shit he was saying. He was like, "I'm not about that, yo. I'm not. They took me back to their house. Like, I'd fuck their daughters, but I'm not about to fuck these two old ladies. Everybody's gonna fucking know."
Yeah,
and Ming's like, "You crazy white boy."
You called him Ming again.
Tomato, tomato.
Yeah, it's so confusing when I'm fucking a girl because I'm like, "I want to fuck you," but then I think about my best friend. Yeah. I think about my best friend all the time. Yeah. I'm fucking you.
It is like an Abbott and Costello bit.
I keep being like, "I want to fuck you, no homo."
Yeah, I want to fuck you. No, not my friend, you.
You.
Yeah, I love you. You.
I love you, you.
Dude, I fucking
You're
love
my
you,
best
you.
Friend ever, you.
Yeah, I call it.
You.
Everyone thinks he has a stutter. He just loves his friend, you.
Yeah, my friend, you is actually in Birkback Mountain, but they CGI'd. No, they're not. That was not him. Yeah, they CGI. Yeah, you guys know CGI? You're the rapper, the drill rapper from Brooklyn, CGI.
You love movie magic.
Yeah, I love movie magic. Yeah, I love movies.
You know, crazy white boy. Oh, yeah. It was so funny, dude.
Yeah, the mayor,
you
what's
crazy
your favorite
Chinese.
Movie?
You crazy white boy. No, you Chinese, you. I really want to see if I can find like a good soundbite from this fucking video.
Boy, you crazy. Yeah.
Matt, yeah. what would your black comedy name be? I Matt, let it burn.
Yeah, my name would be you. Yeah, I can't quit you.
Yeah.
You actually recorded this. I can't really hear it. I thought you were just laughing at him.
What's that? You should give him a try.
Dude, like, honestly, like, I don't. Dude, they was like fucking like 15 years older than me. Like,
oh,
like,
man.
Oh man, dude, he's just doing shit like that the whole time.
Wait, so he was basically just like, oh, that's crazy, his friend.
Yeah, he was just going, damn, that's crazy. You damn. Crazy white boy. He just kept saying shit like that.
That is funny that that's like the equivalent to like your girlfriend being like, oh, that's crazy. Yeah. Everything she says, oh, you crazy white boy.
Oh, you crazy white boy.
He was just letting him know that those two were together. He said, I'm you, you're crazy white boy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, shout out to you. That's a 5-minute long video. There's a lot of gems in there that I was really drunk. It was like 3 a.m, so I don't remember it so well. All right.
Well, goodbye.
If you want to hear more from Lemaire and Noah,
hey, Matt, we're on the way.
Tune into the Patreon.
We're upstairs. We're coming down now. Yep.
All right. Hey, see
Matt.
You guys.
Hey,
thank
Matt.
You for joining
Bye,
the podcast. Wait,
Bye,
watch
Noah.
The camera.
Bye, Noah. Nice meeting you.
See you guys.
See you.
Thank you for joining us. Safe travels back home.
Safe travels.
I'll see you soon. Assalamu alaikum, my brothers.
Ooh, now that LaMare's gone, it's going to smell a little better in here.
Just got a little bit lighter in here.
I do think he was blocking
your apartment can take a load off.
Yeah, the floor just sighed.
I do think he was blocking the fan.
This folding chair just wiped its brow.
Your floor just
went,
screamed.
You. Oh, yeah. You want to join us, Shane? Yeah, true. Yeah, we'll get you next week.
Yeah.
You can join us for the regular episode, though, if you do want. But I do think it's funnier if we only have you on the Patreon. You got to pay for the goods.
Yeah.
You got to pay for the goods.
That's right.
All right. Now what the fuck are we going to talk about? I already talked about you. That's all I had.
That's a good riff, though. You. A guy named you.
I heard Natalie Portman's husband cheated on her.
Oh, she available?
Well, you know, then she called me and she was like, and I was like, Natalie, you know, this is like kind of messy, you know, like
I can't fuck you 6 times.
I don't want to get involved because like this is going to be like a whole tabloid thing and I just don't want to be the other guy, you know.
Well, if she gets divorced, you can make her Natalie Big Chrissy. Instead of Natalie Portman.
Chrissy Portman.
More like Natalie.
You could be Chrissy Portman.
I'm Natalie Portman.
More like Natalie. I'm going to pork that woman.
Well, but then I read that headline about it. And I went back to, you know, on SNL, she did the rap. Did you guys ever see that?
No.
She raps.
That sounds really bad.
No, it's kind of hard. That's the thing. It kind of goes
I think
hard.
You were kind of hard. <in the road. laughs> Boner.
Yeah. No, there's no way that's good.
No,
boner
but,
alert.
But I was laughing thinking about them having her back and she does like a Manhattan drill rap about it. All the people in Hollywood she had, all the people in Hollywood she had to kill.
Yeah. Who do you think she killed?
Yeah, Natalie. Yo, shout out to Natalie.
Natalie Port.
Shout out Port.
Hit my line, salute. Please. Thanks.
Hit up Big Chrissy.
Does she have big
actually,
titties?
Actually, that was not a that was a joke. That was a lie because she already did.
Does she got big titties or little titties? What she got?
I think she, if I had to what guess, I think she has little normal
I
titties.
I think she's petite.
I like that too.
But she's very gorgeous to me.
I think she's quite beautiful.
I think she's quite nice.
Mm-hmm. Oscar winner.
She's quite nice.
Has anything crazy happened to you in La La Land? Did you get molested by any producers or anything?
No, nothing too crazy. I'm trying to think what's been going
did
on.
Did you meet an old man in a parking lot? And did he make you promises about your career?
No, but did I ever tell you guys about the Pizza Hut in my town closing because somebody crafted the pizzas?
No.
Did I ever tell you about that? Okay, so...
I would have remembered this.
Yeah,
I think.
There was a Pizza Hut buffet I used to love... So I have the, because I saved the article because I looked it up recently. Where'd that go? I think it's in deleted. Shit.
Damn.
No, but so.
If it was a Papa John's, that would have been so much funnier though, because then you could have went Papa John's, more like Porta John's.
Yeah, so people are.
Better ingredients, better pizza.
So there's a.
I shit in your pizza.
Better shits.
So there's a Pizza Hut buffet in my town. I used to love the Pizza Hut buffet. I would go in there and.
In La La Land?
No, this is in Richboro, PA, like near where I'm from.
Nice.
And yeah, somebody took a dump in the pizzas. Six employees took a dump in the pizzas. And here's the article.
That's different dumps?
Well, there's a constant thing. It was happening for months and months.
That's like a dump supreme pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, this crust is filled with it.
But I found the article and the comments are so funny.
Stuffed crust.
So yeah. I don't know who Joanna is, but it said... If Joanna or anyone else were wondering what happens when fast food employees do quote unquote unspeakable things to customers' food, just consider what happened yesterday at the Pizza Hut in Richboro. Six employees were fired after a health department investigation at the request and, you know, whatever. But then all the comments were like, I live in Richboro. I know exactly what happened. They were defecating in the pizza sauce. I'm never eating there again. And then the next comment was insane. The next comment was like, I live in the area as well. He's like, I live in the area as well. What would make these people do such a foul thing? These responsible.
Did they say it was just for shits and giggles?
No. But one part where they're like, these are the serial killers gigs. Of tomorrow.
Oh.
Which I don't know. I don't know if that equates to like shitting in pizzas.
Defecating. Yeah. I don't know.
I think you're just doing it for funsies.
Did they kill an animal and throw it in the sauce? Because then we, you know, then that's grounds for maybe serial killer.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. But I'd say shitting in people's food is
that's actually that's
just
signs
below
of,
killing an innocent animal.
That's signs.
Yeah,
of
that's
them,
pretty below.
That's signs of them becoming a gangster.
Yeah, but what's funny is
epic,
that
an epic. Pimp.
That article came out in 2006 and it just didn't close till like 2011.
Damn.
So they, you know, Pizza Hut beat the shit allegations.
Hell yeah.
What's the slogan
like Amber
for
Hurt.
Pizza? What's the slogan for Pizza Hut?
I don't know if they have one.
Pizza Pizza.
Know. No, that's Little Caesars.
Fuck.
Pizza Pizza.
Fuck.
Yeah, you look like a fucking
idiot.
Got that
idiot one wrong.
Now.
God damn it.
It's all right. I'll edit that out.
So mad.
I'll edit that out.
God damn it.
Don't worry.
Fuck. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean to.
Junior
like,
want
up like
to
this.
Not be on my right?
I want to. I didn't mean to fuck up like this on your podcast.
That's right.
And that's a big opportunity. I'm
man,
so
I wish LeMaire was here. He makes every podcast better.
Thanks, man.
No, I'm just kidding.
Thank you so much.
Now I'm just busting your chops.
Yeah.
I'm just busting all over your chops.
Ooh,
now I'm thinking about stuffed crust pizza, but there's not cheese in that crust.
It's dookie.
Remember those commercials with Jessica Simpson? She's like, I have huge tits, but also get the Cheesy Bites pizza.
Jessica Simpson? What is this, 2005?
Yeah, dude.
Oh,
you
shit.
Watch that commercial?
Oh, no. I'm sorry. I don't Big know.
Big Chrissy said
remember.
2005 called. They want their Jessica Simpson back.
Whatever happened to her?
She got fat. She
probably got old.
Yeah, she got old and fat.
She expired.
Yeah. These old broads, they're always expired.
Hollywood out. Called, just kidding.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Just kidding. I'm merciless on this
Big
one.
Big Chrissy pulls no punches.
I'm so eaten. No, I'm just,
go
I'm
up
just
to
kidding.
Random,
I remember.
You just go up to Simpson. Random girls and do that. Be like, Hollywood called. They said, just kidding.
No, they didn't. No one called. That's the joke. You get it?
Damn.
You get
Jessica
it?
Jessica Simpson looking like motherfucking...
No, this is mean. No, I don't mean to be mean.
Dude, don't body shame Jessica Simpson.
She looks good here. She doesn't.
Don't body shame old Jessie.
I don't remember
sorry,
that.
Jessie.
There was she was in a commercial for pizza.
Yeah, pizza.
Sorry,
Jessie.
I was always more of a Bart.
She was
fan,
flashing though. The big titty. Yeah, I was more of a Homer and March fan.
Come oh, on, ladies. Come on, ladies. 1 pound fish. Very, very good. 1 pound fish. Very, very cheap. One pound fish. Well, 5 pound, 4 pound, 1 pound fish. 1 pound fish. 1 pound fish. Come on, ladies. Come on, ladies. That's good, right?
Yeah.
How do you like the podcast so far?
Yeah, I love it. I liked it better when you did say I was Islamophobic at the first thing of the episode.
Oh, my God. Well, you're going to be a big baby about that now.
I'm sorry. Back to Hollywood. No, I'm sorry. Back to Hollywood right now.
You're so Hollywood.
I'm being light-skinned. I'm sorry.
You are.
I don't mean to be light-skinned.
You red bone.
Yeah, I'm a red bone.
I like a long hair, thick red bone. Open up a can of filet mignon.
That song is crazy. Have you ever heard that song recently?
Nah.
That song's nuts. There's one part where the guy says, I give V cards to the retards.
Yo.
And that's wild.
He's giving their virginity back to them?
Yeah. I don't know what that means. Right. It doesn't even make any sense.
1 pound fish. I don't know what the fuck that means either. That's weird.
Yeah. Yeah, that song's insane. I think it's either Gooda Gooda. I forget.
I'm Gooda Gooda. No Stevie Wonder. You see me made it, right? That's it, right?
Yeah, it's gonna go.
You see me wonder. You see me wonder. Oh, she got it, man.
I don't mean
grocery bag.
Yeah. I don't mean to disrupt this, but I don't know what you're talking about.
Big Bedrock Chris is young. By Young Money.
I always forget that Chrissy was born in like 2010.
Baby, I was like to you.
Chrissy, where are you born in 2010?
I was born to Katy Perry.
Yeah.
I was born to last Friday.
It's California Girls. Mm-hmm.
That's you.
California Girls.
Since you moved out west, have you struck gold with any California girls?
I am dating a girl right now.
What's his name?
You're dating a girl.
Did you heard that one, Shane? Who's the girl?
It's a nice girl. I met her.
What's your first and last name?
I'll say the first name, Hunter, which sounds sus. A guy's name.
Lord have mercy.
Matt goes to LA, starts meeting girls named Hunter. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
My girlfriend's name Fisher.
My girlfriend's Bobby name Gatherer.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I sometimes do call her Hunter Biden.
Yeah.
Public.
Oh, that reminds
Hunter
me.
Hunter Biden, get in here.
Yeah. Yo, Hunter Biden. Yeah, what's really on those laptops, bruh?
Damn, you call her Hunter Biden because she's sniffing your crack?
I didn't even think about that one. That's a good one.
She's smoking on your crack.
I don't want to.
Does she ever lick your butt crack?
No. I don't want to talk ill of my lady on here.
Oh, you have a girlfriend? Oh, you have a girlfriend?
I did name drop her.
Oh, you have a girlfriend?
I can lick your ass. Do you want me to edit her name out?
Because
they'll find her if she follows you.
Yeah, maybe not. Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe edit her name out. Yeah. Oh man. Because I do feel like anybody who listens to a podcast, they're just like, especially if they don't like me, they'll be like, yo, let's harass his girlfriend.
No, they won't. That's the thing. I don't think our
fans. Nah, yeah. Our fans are pretty nice still. Yeah. So, fans.
Maybe just bleep it out. Not just fans. Out of safety.
You're not fans. You're friends.
You're friends.
You're listeners.
Uh-huh. You're listeners.
That was gay to say. But talking about Hunter reminded me that I had Joe Biden this morning and fell up my stairs.
Oh, yeah. I showed my dad that compilation of him falling. He's just like, this is the best thing ever.
Even the best fall down sometimes.
I was talking to my mom and she was like, did you see Biden fell today? Yeah.
Dude, the stairs one's so funny because he falls and then he goes back and he falls even further than he did before. And
But he fell. Did you see on the stage?
Yeah, Air Force graduation or whatever. And then he just points. Did you see the Demon Time video?
No. What's the Demon Time video?
Demon Time is a great Twitter account, which I'm not sure who runs it, but I think it's just like the Barstool Bros. Mm. And I found out about it, and they make the best videos. Shout out Demon Time.
Well, it's funny. I was talking to my mom about the recent fall, and she was like, yeah, they must have assembled that stage poorly. And I was like, I don't think that's what it was.
Man, she's coping. Your mom is just simping. She's Joe Biden. She's
loop-pilled as hell.
No, she's loopy as hell.
No, I think she just felt bad for Joe that he fell, which I could understand, but... It was,
yeah, you could feel bad for him, but he's still an 80-year-old man.
Yeah.
That's in like, you know, he can barely.
You see the one where he fell off the bike? It was just like a pause.
The bike was we were just talking about this. We were just talking about this on the Matt and Shane cast, and
that's crazy.
The bike was the worst one.
Yo, Joey Biden. That's a good one. I've seen this. The purple devil emoji is funny. That had devious smile.
Yeah, that's
on
what
him.
Demon Time. Demon Time just does that for everything.
Yo, when you ever on Demon Time, you ever go like this? You ever like, yo,
this is you on Demon Time. Oh, Shawnee's clowning you on Demon Time.
Are you doing? Oh fuck! Fuck! God damn it! Oh, is he doing the bunny ears on me?
Send your ass back to Hollywood.
When you
with
guys,
your tail
when you guys go Demon
legs.
Time, does this
God
happen?
Damn it!
Does this happen to you guys?
Oh, Mr. Rage.
Dude, bunny ears.
Hi, Mr. Rage. Hi, Mr. Rage.
Yeah, you ever got
that's the best song.
I'm like Donnie Darko.
You guys ever go to a
I'm really like Donnie Darko right
Chrissy
now.
Darko.
You guys ever go to a wake and put bunny ears on the dead guy?
I'm like, no, Donnie. But I draw penises on their face and stuff like it's a sleepover.
Yo,
that's what we should do. The next funeral, next one of our, if our, one of our friends ever passes away,
yeah,
even if it's a closed casket, we'll have to open it up and just draw like insert penis here on their chin with the arrow to their mouth.
Yeah,
just put a stick figure that says you're gay. Yeah. Assuming that their family isn't at the.
No, they will be. We'll just have to be sneaky about it.
Sorry, he agreed to this before he died. That's just the thing we're gonna do. We're gonna come on his face.
Yeah, it's actually,
no, that's not what I'm saying.
Oh, dude, I thought we were trying. I thought you said, told us not to work blue, Chrissy.
Right, big Chrissy hates.
Chrissy doesn't
blue.
Want us to work blue, but he's blue.
No,
as hell.
I never said.
Yo, Chrissy's so blue. The shoes are blue.
Dabu
di
dabu die.
I guess you could say I'm wearing
dabu die. Dabu di dabu die. Dabu di dabu die. Yeah,
Chrissy's
sorry,
too young for that one.
Yeah,
Chrissy was born blue. In 2012.
I know that song. I like that one.
Sure you do.
I'm blue.
Sure.
Makes me think of Big Fat Liar.
Ooh.
There's a funny part in that song where it changes for a second, where the guy's like, "I am blue and I'm a and I'm a little crazy."
He breaks it down. Yeah.
I'm a little blue guy.
Blue. Was that the Blue Man Group who sings that, or is that
no?
Different?
The Blue Man Group doesn't sing. I don't think.
No, Blue Man Group, that blue song is just about a
they
crazy guy
garbage.
Who just want to be blue.
Yeah, want to be blue sad or blue like color?
No, I think he's just blue.
Ooh,
he's blue. Dabba dee dabba da.
Dabba dee dabba da.
Interpretation.
Dabba dee dabba da.
Man, I had a long day in the podcast factory today.
Yeah, they're working you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
working me to the bone. But hey,
yeah, bad to the bone.
Got to work for your keep. You know,
got to work for your keep.
Mm-hmm. Someone's got to bring home the bacon around here.
Yeah. Did I ever tell you?
Buy Big Chrissy a new pair of shoes.
Oh.
No.
How long have you had these kicks?
No, these are good shoes.
How long have you had these kicks?
Yeah, those are nice.
I'm blue, dabble. I've had them for dabble, I think, dabble, nine. Two or three years, maybe.
Ooh, 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. I got complimented on these shoes outside of your apartment, outside of here one day. A guy was like, hey, cool shoes.
Thanks, old brother.
And I kissed him on the forehead.
Thanks, old brother.
Hey, thank you.
Yo, I love kissing guys on the forehead.
Thank you. What's your phone number? Thank you.
Give me your digits.
Yo, remember our handshake?
We should be friends.
Yeah.
That's what I said. Thank you. Hey, we should be friends.
That
would
hang
be a
out
good
more.
I mean,
line.
Your shoes aren't as cool as mine, but like we can be friends. But I appreciated
I don't
the
think
compliment.
You
we could
that.
Be friends.
I don't think you would have liked that one bit.
But why not?
Because he wants to. I don't know.
I'm just kidding.
I am too.
I'm never going to say anything to anyone on the street. I never do.
Same.
Do you guys. I don't know. Do you guys talk to people on the street?
Sometimes. Lemaire does all the freaking time.
Lemaire does?
Oh my God. He just bothered some Hispanic lady on the way here. He'll like get out of his car and like ask people to pet their dog.
Dude.
It's just like a huge fat black guy it's running sweet, at a dude. White lady with a dog. And he's like, can I pet that dog?
Yeah.
Lemaire, like, eek. They go, eek.
I remember a few years ago, Lemaire and I went to this like open mic in Princeton. It was at like the Princeton Hyatt. And we were just like fucking around beforehand. there's like a swimming pool, and there's like just a lady clearly like guarding the door, and he's like, can I go swimming? Can I go in the swimming pool? And she's like, are you staying at the hotel? He's like, no, but I want to go in the pool.
Yeah.
She's like, well, you can't go in the pool. He's like, I want to go in the pool. It's just, he's just crazy, those two arguing. Like, can I go in the pool? He's like, no, you can't.
Then he jumps in and just drowns. Oh, Lamezy.
Didn't you have an accusation about a comedian that they can't swim?
Oh, that's another lie. I do that lie a lot.
Yeah.
I tell people that friends of mine don't know how to swim.
That's such a funny lie because it's so believable and you can't really... They can't really prove you wrong right away.
I think that's a Vlad TV thing that they, I think it was, I forget who was on Vlad TV, but someone said that Michael Jordan, greatest basketball player of all time, he doesn't know how to swim.
A lot of people don't know how to swim.
That's kind
of
fucking racist.
Like Jimmy Butler. Remember the thing with Jimmy Butler and Tyler Hero?
Jimmy Buckets actually. Yeah, wait. Yeah. Oh, yes. But what the heck was that?
Okay, so it was Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, and Tyler Hero.
And, Bam Margera Adebayo.
And so, yeah. So
he
Jimmy
said Bam Margera and then made a bunch of African sounds. Bam Margera
Abadayamu. So like ESPN.
That's a mix of two.
Who's your favorite player on the Miami? Bam Margera Abadayamu.
Bam Margera Abadayamu. No, but ESPN was doing like an interview and they were like interviewing those three. And Jimmy Butler just said he can't swim. And then, Tyler Hero was like, yo, me too. And they're like, oh, man, you got some hood energy in you, bro.
Yeah, I do remember that.
You got that,
that
hood in you.
Yeah, Tyler Hero. And then he gets carried away. He's like, never mind.
That's it now.
He's like, I don't remember to pay my child support payments either.
He didn't say that.
I know. That's a joke.
I feel like Joe Rogan just not understanding things.
He's like getting carried away. And just be. He's lying, obviously. Yeah. He obviously knows how to swim.
Yeah.
He's a little too excited.
Yeah.
He's like, I don't know how to swim either.
He's like, I don't like when people touch my hair.
I am actually
trying to be as black as
like,
possible.
Tyler, get out of here, dude. Yeah.
I am a very bad swimmer.
You are?
I'm a terrible swimmer. I remember, like, I was like, I like doggy paddle fine. Maybe I can't swim. I don't know. I'm outing myself.
Doggy paddle?
Yeah, I'm really bad. I'm a really bad swimmer.
That's okay.
Yeah, I remember. It's fine. I remember I felt like I was drowning, like in very shallow water. It's very bad.
That's all right, remember one time.
Yeah,
I would never let you drown.
Nah, dude. Yeah, you're gonna save me.
I'd save.
I remember one time in the summer.
Save me. Oh, I'm drowning. Oh, Chrissy used to be a lifeguard.
Me too.
You guys were both lifeguards?
Yeah, we'd save you.
The tide once took me.
We'd pull you out of the water and then kiss you until you
came
back.
As a boy, the tide took me at the beach and I started screaming.
You do got the Larry Lobster build on you, bro.
And then this my neighbor, this old lady, was like, oh, hey, Christian, I saw you having some trouble in the water. I was a kid, but I was still like embarrassed. I was embarrassed. I was like, oh, yeah.
No, I had it all under control.
Yeah, I'm fine. I was like,
That blasted undertow got you.
I heard you having some trouble, and it was just me in the water like, help! Help!
Were you on Strong Island?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, I was.
They got you? You were yelling at the beach. They didn't even know.
I was yelling on the beach a different way.
Yeah, but they couldn't tell the difference.
Help!
They're like, oh, that's
my red hair bobbing in and out.
Yeah.
Help!
It's like a buoy.
Help! This older lady approached me. Oh, I heard. Saw you having some. There was no urgency. Like no one yeah. Really. This is Christian. God, I think he'll be okay.
You were a goner.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Well, I'm here. Can I have some watermelon, please?
Watermelon.
That's what we cut up at the beach and eat.
I love watermelon at the beach.
Yeah, I like a juicy, big juicy watermelon.
Yeah, big succulent.
I like when my mouth
watermelon.
Gets wet. I like when my wild mouth gets wet.
Yep. And then you get the seeds. You can eat them now, you know.
My wild.
I got a wild mouth when I eat that watermelon.
1 pound fish.
You're not even describing how you eat. You're just describing your mouth. That's wild.
You sound like Zoidberg.
No, there's nothing preempting that.
You wild mouth.
Man. I eat so great. No, just my wild. What's my wild mouth?
Your mouth's got a mind of its own.
Yeah, I got my mouth's got a mind.
Wild ass mouth.
Man, I should say mouth. I said while I'm eating pussy, I'm like in the middle, just bob my head up. My mouth's got a mind of its own, baby.
Are you ready for my wild mouth?
Yeah.
Buckle up, baby. Yeah.
You guys, you guys ever eat pussy and you bob your head up and you'd be like, man.
No homo.
Got a wild mouth.
Man, this is the best night of my life.
This is phenomenal.
You're eating pussy. I love this. Pop up and go, thank you so much, by the way. I can't thank you enough for this experience.
This is so good.
And you kiss
her
on her forehead.
Eating your pussy. I love the lips. I like kissing your lips.
Oh, my Lord.
Sorry.
You know Big Chrissy doesn't like when you wear blue.
I'm sorry.
I just didn't expect you to go that far.
Chrissy, can I watch you eat pussy one of these days? I want to see if you're doing it right.
Hey, yo, happy pride. See if you're
loving the ladies.
Oh, and this is my friend Matt. And then you're just, hey, hey.
Yeah, I just want to see if you're loving
the
ladies.
He's just making sure I'm doing
it right.
Just
supporting my boy.
Yeah.
You bring a little audience with you.
Yeah.
No,
I want to see if you're doing that.
No, that will never happen.
The peanut gallery.
Yeah. Chrissy
the penis
champ.
Gallery.
No, Chrissy don't eat no gallery. Pussy. You know what Chrissy does? He just says, hey. My mouth got a mind of its own. I don't want to do that shit.
Big Christian mad, light skin with it.
My mouth a little too wild for pussy. Yeah. My mouth's too wild for pussy.
Yeah. Yo,
yeah, you got a feral mouth.
Yo, you got to put caution tape on that mouth because it's too wild.
That's why
edgy comedians have
mouth,
a caution tape.
Because their mouth's too wild. Mm-hmm. My mouth is so crazy. When I see pussy, I go, get that away from me.
Get that away. I got a motor mouth. I'm going to go.
You're not going to like me.
Yeah.
When I'm horny.
What's the, trying to think. Sean, what is the, what's the dumbest thing you've said during lovemaking?
Oh, I don't remember. I block every negative experience out. I have a bad memory as it is.
Oh, yeah.
Let me try to think. I bet, I don't know.
I got some.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, go ahead. You go.
I remember I was eating pussy.
It sounded like you asked me a question that you wish I asked you.
Yeah, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's you with the HBU. IDK, HBU.
HBC. Wait, what about it?
Not HBCU. Oh, wow. That's probably where your story took place.
No, but watch it.
Matt Byrne likes... ladies.
what
you say likes ladies?
You get the picture.
I think you left out one.
I know, but they get what I'm saying.
I remember I was having sex with a girl.
Matt Byrne likes black
black people.
I remember once I was having sex with a girl.
Oh, shucks. Oh, bother.
Remember once I was having sex with a girl, I'm like...
Come off it. Come off it with me talking... with me liking black women. Come off it.
No, this is crass.
Sorry, go ahead.
My face red as hell now.
Sorry, go ahead.
I'm a little blue... Yeah, I look like a blueberry. I'm all...
You look like a Native American. The red man come.
I know. I look really blushy. No, but one time I was having sex with a girl, and I was like, oh, man, this is awesome.
Awesome sauce? You hit with the awesome sauce?
Yeah, like, this is
like
awesome.
You were at a water park?
Yeah. And she just goes, what? And I'm like,
sorry, I meant this is epic. No, I'm sorry, I meant...
Oh, yeah. Epic cringe moments I'm having.
One time I ate a girl's pussy, and
cringe.
I go, this tastes so good. I'm just like...
My compliments to the chef.
Wait, was that real?
I go, this tastes so good. You know how like sometimes you get like super like in the moment?
Yeah, yeah.
And you're just like, this tastes so good.
Yeah, I'm sure I've done
the best thing I can come up with.
You turn into Woody Allen.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Oy vey, your pussy tastes amazing.
I love your pussy. It's so scrumptious.
Scrumdiddlyumptious.
Oh, I don't even have to go to therapy this week because it tastes so good.
Because your pussy's so good.
Oh, the pussy's so good. I can cancel therapy. Oh, boy.
Hello, doctor. I don't need to come in.
Doctor,
something has happened. This pussy was delicious.
Oh, I ate it so good. You should have seen it. It was like my movie Manhattan. It was so impressive. Oh boy.
Come on, ladies.
Oh boy.
Come
you on, know, I heard Chrissy's ticklish. Is that true?
He is. He's very ticklish.
Is this the same phone call? What the hell?
Chrissy's very ticklish. She is.
That'd be funny if like Woody Allen was like obsessed with Chrissy. It was just like, oh, I love Chrissy. I listen to the podcast all the time. He's so adorable. I would love to get pegged by Chrissy.
Oh, my Lord.
No, I'm sorry.
Now, this is blue.
I'm sorry. I'm being blue.
This is so blue.
No, I'm sorry. This is blue-collar comedy. I'm very blue-collar.
Sean, did you just look at the time and go, damn,
into the mic? Yeah.
No, I'm so sorry for ruining the podcast.
How much time have we got?
Damn.
Goddamn.
Damn. We've been doing it for 5 minutes.
Am I your worst podcast guest?
No, you're the best.
No, oh, you're sorry, Matt sorry. Byrne. You're one of our best friends.
Okay.
Yeah, we're your bestie, dude. We love you.
I'm afraid your audience
is
going to hate me.
I'm so happy to see you.
I'm happy
it's
to see you.
It's a shame that the only reason you wanted to hang out with us, though, is because you wanted to do the podcast.
No, that's not true. That's not true.
Matt Byrne texted me and said, what is your availability for these dates? For the podcast. He did not ask us to hang out. He asked us to do the podcast.
No, that's not true. That's not true. Don't say that.
You're Hollywood now.
No, I'm not.
That's why I call you Hollywood.
Well, because I would assume we would hang out in the city. And then I also
we should go hang out. We should go to a bar after this. Summer.
Yeah, let's go. You want to get pizza?
I mean, yeah, we can. Yeah. I guess we can do that instead.
Well, I wanted to hang. That's bullshit. Because I also wanted to hang out with you in the Philly area. With McCuskey, but I had to. Yeah,
to
I
couldn't get out there. I know. I'm sorry for putting you on notice.
Yeah, you guys are being mean.
I know. I love you. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
Everybody,
I love you too.
Matt Byrne is the best.
No, Matt is the best.
Your audience is gonna be like, this kid's fucking gay.
No.
No, it's all good.
No, Matt Byrne's my oldest friend in comedy.
Yeah, that's very true.
At Temple remember, U. Oh, we could talk about the time that you helped me out at Temple. It was probably the first night I met you.
Oh, yeah.
We were walking from Cave back to Temple's campus.
Beep, beep. You want to touch it?
Beep,
beep. That's so funny. Beep, 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 beep.
That's so funny. Damn, I'm happy you're here. Big Chrissy hates when I touch him on the podcast.
I do. I do hate it. I don't like it. Burn's turning into a toddler. It seems. Burn just offered to take out his penis and let us play with it.
Yeah, you want
to
play with it? I kind of like when you were a kid. Do you ever do this thing with your soft penis where you pretend it's an airplane and you go bee?
No.
It's like you do that now.
Yeah. Actually, I did do that recently because you know when you're like really sick and you can't take a shower. So
you start playing with your
penis. I don't know that.
I don't relate to this. I'll keep going.
You know when you're really sick and then you just look down at your penis.
I remember I couldn't stand up. My tummy was hurting a lot, so I took a bath and I was playing with my penis and I just go bee.
I thought you were going to say that's how you get your girlfriend to suck it. No. You're like, here comes the plane.
I did do that.
Nagasaki.
I did do that to a girl once.
Pearl Harbor.
I did do that with a girlfriend once. She was just like sitting on the couch and I have my cock out and I go,
this is a kamikaze pilot.
Yeah. I go, here comes the plane.
Wait, but I wanted to tell the audience
about some story.
Yeah, recount
your wholesome story.
No, what's a story? You recounted a story to me that night because you were showing me how to get from Cave back to Temple's campus, and you were like, "Yeah, here's a way." Because one time, a guy tried to give me some trouble, and then.
Uh-oh.
You have your story.
Oh, is this the faking Down syndrome one?
Oh yes, that's the best. Yes.
Oh yeah. Oh, you guys want me to tell it? I like this story.
It was one.
You don't want to tell it. You don't have to.
I love to tell it.
It was one of the first things I knew about.
Oh, yeah, it's so funny. Yeah, you're like 17, and I'm like, hey, stranger, you want me to?
Well, no, you were like, here, I'll show you how to get back, and I was I appreciate it, and you were like, yeah, one time. It's one time I got tried to rob me, and I pretended I had done something. Yeah, because I was like, oh,
yeah, because you're like walking your direction. I'm like, oh, don't go near the Wendy's. A guy mugged me, and then I had to pretend I had
a guy mugged you near the Wendy's. I love that. Wendy's.
Yeah, well, that's why I kind of it was a little farther down. No, it was a little farther down.
It was it was in front of like Leah Chorus Center, like right there.
Well, do you know what's weird is it started there, but then it kind of ended a little like farther out. So he was like, I was trying to walk and he was like pacing with me. So what happened was I was walking home from Shamu Boogaloo.
Yeah.
That like backyard show. Mm-hmm. And I was dressed like such a dildo. I was wearing like a shirt with boats on it. Like a shirt from Ross.
You were fitted up.
Yeah, yeah. And I got
fitted up to be mugged.
Yeah. And from Wendy's, I bought this is so embarrassing. I bought 4 crispy chicken sandwiches.
God damn. You quadrupled it?
Yeah.
You said quadruple sizes.
Yeah.
3. So, you know what? Let me get 4.
I got 4. And then
3's a crowd.
A guy. So 4 actually. Is,
4's just right.
So it wasn't near the Wendy's. I had just gotten Wendy's. So it wasn't near the Wendy's. But I was going like towards. You know, my apartment. And you know how, like, especially towards your building at the time, there was like walls, kind of, that like the white walls.
Yeah.
So I'm like walking near one of those guys and then one of those things. And this like homeless guy, I don't even know if he was homeless. He was just a crazy guy. He pinned me against the thing.
Damn.
He's like, give me all your money. And I'm like, and then I was just like, my brain was thinking at a mile a minute because I'm like, what people do even the shittiest people have empathy for? And I'm like, oh, Down syndrome. I'm going to fake having Down syndrome. So I put my hand over my ears and I said the same sentence like 40 times. I said, mommy, I want to go home. Mommy, I want to go home. Mommy, I want to go home. And it was a
genius.
And what's crazy is he was just like, oh, what the fuck? And then I kept trying to say other things too, because I was like, I just said nonsense. I was like, I want to go to the pot. And I was like saying just gibberish. And like,
went retard mode.
Yeah. And then I just saw like apartment force lights. I saw
yeah. Force field.
Force field.
I'm on base, actually.
Actually, speaking of force field, I have something funny for that.
Okay. Well, put a pin in that.
Yeah, yeah, it was a game of manhunt.
Well, actually,
you were safe.
The funny thing I forgot to say about the pinning. So when he pinned me, all the crispy chicken sandwiches fell out.
like Sonic, out. Dude.
Yeah. It was like,
you lost all your loot.
Yeah. I lost all my loot. So then so all the lights turn on. He goes, he like yells like, what the fuck are you doing? And I go, I'm just making noise. And then he runs away. And then I'm like, oh shit, I gotta go back. But what's kind of funny,
I gotta go get my crispy chicken sandwiches.
No, I left them. They're on the ground.
No.
What's kind of funny is I was like sprinting back home and one person was like, are you okay? And they saw me do the Down syndrome voice. And I was like, yeah, I'm fine. And they're like, what were you doing? Why are you sounding like that?
A character.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, I gotta go.
Ever heard of improv?
But
fucking idiots.
I was yes anding.
I had a really like tumultuous relationship at the time, and my girlfriend was staying at my place, and she would like, so this is like how much we would argue, or like how much she like didn't like me anymore. So we had sex one time and she yelled at me. She was like, oh, like I was inside of her and she goes, oh, is that a sock on the ground? Like it was that bad. So I went back.
Oh, jeez.
I went back to,
you should have put
apartment.
It on the doorknob.
Yeah. And you went, no, those are my chicken sandwiches.
Yeah. So I went back to my apartment and she was like there and I was so sweaty, but she was also like, she was one of those people who didn't like any type of like joke or just didn't think it, like she thought everything was like offensive.
I remember this girlfriend, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. But so I went and I didn't even tell her what happened because she would probably get mad at me for like faking having
for being a genius.
Yeah, for being a genius,
for leaving your chicken sandies behind.
So
that's offensive.
Yeah.
That's blue.
Oh no, I didn't even mean it. I didn't even mean it that offensive.
Yeah, so
but Matthew, it was offensive.
You done left all the present chicken behind.
Oh jeez. No, so I like went back.
You went back to your apartment.
Yeah, so
she's just like, where's the chicken?
Oh fuck!
You said you were bringing home 4 chickens.
You fucking.
I'm sorry.
Oh man.
I got mugged. She said, "Okay, but where's the fucking chicken?"
No, but then I was afraid to tell her.
No, that's not right. I'm sorry. That's
that
not
is
right.
Not
so
right.
I was like,
apologies on behalf of the Super Ultimate Audio
that
Visual
is,
Experience.
That's I'm sorry.
So I came home sweaty.
Me so sorry.
I came home sweaty. So I just like laid in the bed sweaty. And she's like, oh, aren't you going to take a shower first? And I was like, fuck.
Damn.
So I got like a huge argument.
That sucks. Yeah, I remember her. I do. I remember like coming to shows and being cranky the whole time, right? It was that girlfriend?
Yeah, she was a little cranky.
Is that the one that we went to Good with that one time?
Oh yeah, she hated Nick Mullen so much.
yeah.
She hated. Oh, I remember.
That was when Kevin O'Fee asked Nick Mullen how we were like a year into comedy and we went to go see Mullen.
Yeah.
And then Kevin O'Fee met him outside and said, what did he say? He was like, man, nice Apple Watch. See all that cocktail money's paying off.
Yeah, Kevin's such an idiot.
And Nick just like walked away.
Yeah.
Oh, man, my voice just went really high. No. It was ridiculous. Yeah,
you had a little tee-hee.
I did do a tee-hee.
That was nice. I liked it.
Oh, the force field thing. So
regale us.
I've been reading 25 hours of the Steve Jobs audiobook, and when he lies,
you've been listening to it.
No, I've been reading.
You've mostly been reading the audiobook?
Yeah, I've been reading the audiobook.
Okay, go on.
I've been reading. So he calls
25 hours is so long.
I'm not done with it. I'm like 11 hours, only 11 hours in. Mm-hmm. But he's like a pathological liar throughout the whole thing. And he calls it a reality distortion field. He doesn't call it lying. So he's just like, no, I'm not lying. You just entered my reality distortion field.
That's awesome.
Like just willingly lying. And he's just
like that a lot.
Yeah. And
that's insane.
Well, what's so funny is it became such a thing that the company started referring to it. There's actually a chapter that goes Steve's reality distortion field in quotes. Yeah.
He's like, I'm not lying. I'm just a sorcerer. I'm distorting reality. I'm Dr. Strange.
No, he was comparing himself to a Buddhist. He was like, actually, it's kind of like Zen to create your own reality.
Well, he's not. He's like a psycho asshole, apparently.
No, he's a good guy. Don't say that about Steve Jobs.
Don't speak on
Steve Jobs. No,
I love Steve Jobs.
Steve Jobs and I have everything in common.
I love my job.
Except for being smart. He's got the smart thing, but he has like all these weird quirks where he's just like, he's a super, like, he's basically like an autistic guy. Like, he just had nothing in his apartment.
You know what this is, dude?
What?
It's a brain sucker. You know what it's doing?
What?
Sucker. Starving. Got you.
No, but he was
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to touch you. I keep touching you.
It's hard not to. No, but he was
miss you, dude.
He was like so autistic. Like when his wife bought a couch, he got freaked out. He's like, oh, that might be too much stuff. I don't know if I can handle a couch.
He's a minimalist.
Yeah, he's a minimalist, which basically is autism. It's just being like, there's too much stuff. It's overwhelming. Yeah. He's like, I just need black t-shirts and just like a stove.
I need black t-shirts and for you to get the fuck away from me.
Yeah.
He abandoned his kid. That's gotta go.
I didn't know about the reality distortion field.
Yeah, reality distortion field. Oh, it's kind of funny.
That's what I'm going to do whenever my mom enters my room. Reality distortion field.
I am not masturbating right now. Mom, get out. Mom, get out of my room.
I'm not watching male transport right now. Yeah. I'm not watching a guy with a pussy. That's just your distorted reality.
Yo, you and LeMaire on the same tip?
No, but this reminds me of something that...
I'm not on that wave.
One time at the Titan House.
Happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride Month. But I'm not on that wave.
One time I was at the Titan
Happy
House.
Happy Pride Month, but I'm not on all that goofy shit.
I'm not on that.
I'm not with that funny shit, but happy Pride Month to y'all.
Yeah.
Happy Pride.
Did I send you the Ray J video where it's like happy Pride Month to all my gay N-words?
Yeah, you did. That's good. That's good stuff.
Ray J's the
Maybe
man.
That'll be the intro this week. That's good. Right? Do you think we're allowed to do that or do you think that's offensive?
No, that's not offensive. That's funny.
There is that whole
about it in the staff meeting.
I read it. I read a headline once that using like GIFs or
using digital blackface.
You're actually very racist for doing that. Apparently,
that
thing I've been doing for 10 years.
I'm in the Klan. Turns out I'm as racist as it gets.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny that that's like the cause people are going at now. It's like not like actual racism.
Come on, that gif of the little kid where he's like, the guy who's filming the kid who's like, you're Terrio, or like they think, and the kid
ooh,
is like,
kill him.
Oh, no, you can't use the Octavia Spencer eye roll gift. That's so offensive. Yeah. You can't use the gift from Mama. Yeah. You fucking racist. Have you guys been watching? Have you ever seen Mama?
Nah.
Oh, it looks good.
Mama looks good.
You guys want to watch Mama after
Mom
this?
With a, no, Mom, I don't have a TV.
Get pizza to watch Mama. We can watch it on her phone.
You see, no. You see Octavia Spencer in Mama?
Yeah.
Mama look good.
Mama look good.
Mama look fine as a motherfucker.
Oh, no. Yeah.
1 pound fish.
You guys,
come on, ladies.
Did you guys see Kanye's new clothes?
Yeah,
he's wearing like a shoulder pads and
Lego man.
He does.
He's a savage now.
He is a savage. Wears
shoulder classy, pads bougie, and ratchet. On. He
Shout
wears
out,
sassy, moody,
he
nasty.
Wears shoulder pads and like stormtrooper boots, yeah, like big moon boots. Yeah,
yeah.
He's Luke Skywalking on these haters.
Man, you're ripping it.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, can we beatbox and Chrissy start freestyling?
Go ahead, spit.
Oh, you hit him with the yuck, yuck, yuck.
Start freestyle, Chrissy.
You're an interesting you're an interesting critter, bro.
Yeah. Yo, I'm such a critter. Yeah, I'm such a critter. I'm gonna tickle you all over. Oh,
no, he's tickle. The tickle critter.
You were going for the tickle, but you pressure pointed me. You hit me right on the part of your neck.
Yeah.
Oh my god,
Chrissy.
That was an aggressive tickle.
No, yeah.
Wait, can you lay down another tasty beat?
Whoa, that one, this one's French.
Oh, I'm good.
You went, oh. Whoa.
I said freestyle, Chrissy. What you doing?
You're just so
what
Hollywood.
What you twerking with, Chrissy? Come
what
on,
are you twerking yourself? With?
What you twerking
Chrissy, what
with,
are
fam?
You twerking with?
Freestyle for a brother, huh? You going to freestyle
God,
for a brother?
Badge lost his mind. Dude, you lost it in Hollywood.
We need to get the shot for Matt.
I'm sorry, when you check the time, I need to bring the energy up.
No, I'm not checking.
I'm checking the levels. Well, I'm checking the levels. I love how the book says squeaky clean cup.
That's to remind me that Chrissy wants me to wear clean.
All right, no. I'll lay down the beat.
Yo, that should slap for real.
Yo,
fuck that shit up, Matt.
Yo,
producer Matt.
Matt burn on the beat.
Fuck that
burn,
shit up,
burn. Burn on the beat.
Burn, baby, burn.
Actually, you want me to do a freestyle?
Yeah. Wait, I'll do a rap. I'll do a beat this time. I'll do a real simple one, just so you can rap over it.
Yeah, well, a lot of people think I'm gay. Hey, rule one. Stop. Rule one, you can't laugh during the beat.
All right.
True.
We're going to have to start over every time we laugh. Okay. Right. Yeah, turn up the stand on my headphones a little bit. Turn up the stand on my fucking headphones. Turn up the stand on my fucking headphones. Yo, I love Big Chrissy. He's my man. Yo, if you can't do it, nobody can. He's the man, and he likes a little tickle. Yo, pause. Yo, you can't.
You just tickled my stomach.
You can't let the tickle interrupt the beat. You got to keep going. Start over.
All right.
Start over.
Oh my gosh.
All right.
You got your hand ready to tickle me?
Yeah, you got it under pressure. No, I won't tickle you. I promise.
Dude, that'd be a crazy like studio arrangement. The rapper keeps trying to tickle the producer.
Yeah.
It's like Ice Cube trying to tickle Dr. Dre in N.W.A.
He's doing no Vaseline.
Yeah.
All right. Whew.
All right.
Yo, Dre, you got to start that shit again, dude.
Fuck that shit up, Chrissy.
Like,
I love the Straight Outta Compton when the manager just gets so mad. He's like, what did Ice Cube say about us?
Yeah.
Did Ice Cube talk shit about me?
That's Paul Giamatti.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's Paul Giamatti. I just watched that movie lately for the first time.
We're just going to let him say that easy?
Yeah.
We're just going to let him say that?
What's your name? Wow. You guys got quite a new aggressive sound. What do you guys name? What does NWA stand for? No Whites Allowed? And then he says it, and he goes,
what is that actually in the movie?
Okay, yeah.
Oh, really?
I watched the movie recently for the first time. It was a good movie. Yeah. I liked it.
No Whites
But yeah,
Allowed.
Paul Giamatti, in that movie, he has a white wig, like a hairpiece, and he's still like the best actor ever. Just watching it, like, damn, this guy.
He reused the John Adams wig for the NWA movie.
NWA.
I'm a music producer from 1776.
No,
yeah.
No Whites Allowed. That's what this brother say.
Oh,
music
yeah.
producer.
I got that. Speaking of,
listen to me, Easy. We're gonna go all the way together. You and me.
Sir, are you gonna start the beat again or what?
Yeah, it's a long way to the top if you wanna rock and roll.
Yo. Yo, Chrissy boy, he's my man. If he can't do it, nobody can. Nobody can do it like Chrissy. Keep going.
Nobody can do it like Chrissy.
Nobody can do it like Chrissy.
Nobody can do it like Chrissy.
He's the best.
He's the best.
He's gotten taller.
He's so tall.
He's so tall.
He's like,
I go, is that Jethro
million.
Tall? Because he's so goddamn tall.
Jethro tall.
Why'd you stop?
Yo, cut that, bro. Yeah. Cut that shit up, Quay.
Oh, man.
Jethro Tull.
Jethro Tull.
Did I tell you? But
Jethro Tull.
Did I tell you like
a... Said.
Oh, damn. I actually like it now.
Oh, no.
I shouldn't have stopped the beat.
Yeah. Well, Big Chrissy's like...
Tull.
Big Chrissy, you've been drinking your milk. You gotten so big.
Did I tell you,
I've
like
been eating all this milk.
Did I ever tell you my cat?
You've been eating your
my
milk.
Catfishing hobby I did like a year ago. I don't have this hobby anymore.
Your catfishing hobby?
Oh yeah, I think so.
No, I don't think you heard about this specific one.
Okay,
I remember December 2021. Mm-hmm. I had this weird. I made like this fake Hinge profile with this model from Germany, and you know, you get a lot of like attention, and I would just I would just set up a date with all the girls and all like go to the same place, and then I like forgot I did it like right before a plane ride, and then I get home and all of them are like, where the fuck are you, where are all these other girls? So a bunch of girls just showed up to one
you
place.
Set up a harem?
Yeah, I set up a harem.
Oh, you sent them all to the same place?
Yeah, I sent them all to the same location. I don't know, it was really funny to me.
You're an agent, you're chaos, man.
I guess it's not funny, but it was
no
very,
that's very funny.
Yeah. It's very psychopathic.
You used to do that for real. Your old tactic used to be put a sexy guy as your profile picture
and change it back
and
to
then
mine.
When you match with all the girls, you change it back to yours and then you message them.
Yeah, yeah, that was my strategy. Because one
damn.
Time a girl,
that's
one,
a bait and switch.
One time a girl noticed it and she goes, I'm gonna report you, and I go, well, I'm gonna unmatch.
I'm gonna report you. How's that
jokes
sound?
Yeah,
jokes on you, bitch. I don't even like you.
Yeah, you're not even hot.
No, yeah, I've got. I remember I got caught with the bait and switch twice, and then another girl goes, because another girl like knew me from something, and they're like, Matt, did you just do the bait and switch? And they're like, shit, you got me. How's your love life going, Chrissy boy?
Oh, it's
in
not
shambles.
No, don't say
no,
that.
No,
dude.
No, it's good.
No, I feel
Chrissy's
like
she's the love guru,
dude. I feel like
no, I don't. I don't really have. I don't really have a love life.
Dude, yeah, you got that TikTok following. You should be like, any girl who follows would be like, hey, can I eat your pussy? Looks good. Looks tasty.
Oy no, vey, looks here we go.
Sorry.
Here we go with the blue humor.
I'm sorry,
again.
I didn't mean to be blue. I'm sorry. Can I apologize?
Yeah, of course.
Can I do a public apology, guys?
This
I'm
is
sorry.
A Christian podcast. We forgive. We forget.
I'm sorry for being blue.
It's also a Muslim podcast, so we could seek revenge.
Ooh.
You give, and then you take away.
Man. It's the Lord.
Chrissy's
that's the Lord does.
Were you a big Andrew Tate fan at the time? I remember you text me like, how cool he is.
Fuck you.
I actually was a huge Andrew Tate fan for a while.
I know. You're Sigma as hell.
Yeah, well, because they... Cause
no, I never liked that stuff. Even on this
fan.
Podcast, one
you disavowed him?
No, on this pod, one of the episodes, I vaguely go into being that I'm like kind of an incel, and I even regret that I shouldn't have said that because I'm
ball
really
cell,
you're a
ball cell.
I'm not a
With this piece, you can't be an incel. This piece you got here.
You're a volcel.
Got a piece.
Big Chrissy does not talk about his penis.
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
It's huge.
Just so you know, please.
I'm not a, we'll I'm not a cell.
I'm not. Gardini's got a big one.
I watched
one.
A good documentary. Can I, or
yeah, yeah.
Penis or documentary?
Well, documentary, please.
Yeah. I was gonna say one time at Ortlieb's, I was peeing next to Gardini. I looked over. I go, wait, are you hard? He's like, no. And I'm like, Jesus, that thing's huge. Anyway.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It was so big. Anyway.
I'm glad you like it.
Documentaries.
That's what I said. Oh, I'm glad you like it, Matt.
I watched a documentary about Pepe.
Got a piece on you, bro. Got a piece on you, bro.
This is wrong.
You guys shouldn't have us so close together.
Well, this is by nature of this couch. This is just so what it is.
Yeah. It's a tiny couch. But, it's a love seat. We talk about love. Yeah. We talk about hate.
What about the documentary?
Go on now, big
man. I watched a documentary about Pepe the Frog.
What?
Jesus Christ, big fella.
No, it's a good documentary. It's called Feels Good, Man.
And it's about the guy who made it who's like bummed.
Yeah, it is. It's about
I heard about that.
About an artist, this guy who, you know, he makes this kind of quirky, funny cartoon. And then Pepe the Frog gets taken and turned into this like horrible internet thing. And it was good. It was a good documentary. But anyway, they interview a guy in that who's like a Pepe head, a weird online guy who's like, yeah, this is my mom's basement.
Welcome to the Fortress of Dreams.
Yeah. He's like, it's pretty wild in here, but this is just how I live.
I love frogs.
But,
the Fortress of Dreams. So
but that he's the window into like the world of like online, and it's bad. It's like terrible.
So he's the mastermind.
So my point, but my point though is that there may have been times where I've come off like that on the pod, and I really don't want to.
Everyone knows you're a good soul, bro.
I was just thinking of that guy having your everyone interest you and being heart. Like. And I'm like, didn't you watch Vlad TV? Vlad TV's had some sexy content recently.
Well, actually, I think I heard Rogies talk about Pee Pee the Frog.
Ooh.
Pepe?
Pee Pee the Frog.
Pee Pee.
Pee Pee?
And
Pee-pee?
He said the artist was like, no, it's not alt-right. And then they're just like, yeah, okay, dude.
Well, that's what happens in the documentary. They have this guy who actually was a social...
Stop it!
He was a social media person for Trump, this one guy that they interview. And he's like, he thought he could have stopped it just by being like, it's bad. But this guy clearly doesn't know the internet. And then it actually got worse. But I felt for the artist. I like that guy. I think they've been able to since claim like... copyright on its usage
on PP
copyright PP.
But no, the guy is good natured. Like it's like he's a well intentioned guy. But I think people took his
sounds
stuff.
Like sounds like a lib.
They
to
took
me.
My frog.
No, he took it.
They took my frog.
Well, it got like crazy and bad.
These immigrants are coming over and taking our frogs.
They're taking my frog.
They're taking the frog.
They better not be taking the frog.
You woke up. The
I
frog.
Know that's right. They're not taking no frog.
Was it this?
They're not. Taking a frog now.
Oh shit, we cooking, boys.
They're not taking a frog without a fight.
Was the Pepe guy also the McDonald's guy?
He probably got the same IQ.
How be funny that.
McDonald's. Me and my mom and my dad.
That video
are going to
amazing.
The Pride Parade.
Did I read a 1-star review of our podcast?
Oh, brother, we don't want to read that.
I know, but this guy, he wrote...
We don't want to get into that.
Big Chrissy is the worst excuse for a comedian, except for when he does the frog thing, which is very funny. This was a review that this guy left. He gave it 1-star. He was like, keep doing the frog thing, Chrissy. But
it's on site with that, brother.
Shit on me, like, so hard and so instantly.
It's on site with that, brother. Fuck that, brother.
Wait, what's the frog thing?
The frog.
It's Chrissy's character where he talks like an old cage man.
Never heard the frog before.
No,
oh my lord. That was
you just woke the frog up.
I gotta bring Matt in on the frog.
We gotta bring you to the bayou.
Is that why you bring Pepe in? So you do
No, it really wasn't. But I also got.
You just thought about the 1-star review. You're like, I gotta tie this in somehow.
No, yeah. No, I did think of the 1-star review, but I didn't connect it to Pepe.
We did get a good... Well, we got a funny review where someone said that I'm SpongeBob, Big Chrissy's Patrick, and that is a funny comment.
I like that. Yeah, I like that.
That is true.
Yeah.
Wombo.
Yeah.
Who you calling Pinhead?
Can I talk to Chrissy the Frog?
Yeah, we can close it out. We're at like an hour 10 though, so let's
we should do 3 hours. That'd be sick.
Well, we don't have much time on the SD
card. I wish I had brought up the SD.
What does that stand for?
Sug dick.
Oh, fuck.
I wish I had brought up the frog earlier.
Yo, you're wild on the cash, bro.
No, I'm really ticklish.
You're so Hollywood. When the camera goes on, you start being brazy.
Brazy.
When the bamra goes on, you start being brazy.
No, I just, you know, it's weird. I kind of like being tickled a little bit, but then I don't like it if it's too long.
I think that's everyone's kind of feeling about it.
Yeah. That's why I was afraid to get in the middle because I'm like, I'm in perfect tickle position. I'm perfect.
I wouldn't do it. I don't want to do it
because he hates touching his friends.
I don't.
Yeah.
Not me.
He hates touching his friends.
I'll grab you all up.
Yeah, Big Chrissy hates touching his friends.
He does.
Not me, though. I touch all my friends.
Yeah, Big Chrissy hates tickling his friends.
No, yeah.
I don't do it. I'm uncomfortable around.
Big Chrissy, he's not a lover. He's a fighter.
I'm not either. I'm just kind of
aloof.
You're
very combative, Chrissy. You won't tickle us.
Combative Chrissy.
He's very aggressive. He didn't try to tickle me once.
I was just thinking. Remember during the pandemic, we did those weird calls.
Yeah, we would Skype each other.
Yeah, those were crazy.
And then we
needed a pal to talk to.
Yeah, that was so fun.
In those uncertain trying times.
Yeah, and then like for certain people, as they're talking, they would just be like, "You'd be like, shut up." They'd be kicked out.
Yeah. Like, shut up.
Were you guys there during the when I was saying I have a hole in my shoe?
Oh my god!
This is like a psycho bit. This is like a crazy bit.
You don't say.
This is the craziest thing.
This is the craziest.
So during the pandemic, and everybody, nothing was going on, and for whatever reason, we were talking. It was like 2 a.m, and for some reason, this thing started where I'm like, I say this, you guys repeat, and if you don't repeat it exactly, we start over. So it was like, I have a hole in my shoe. And people would be like, what's in the hole? Like, everybody would say the same exact thing.
Yeah.
And some people would be like, what's so in dumb. The hole? And somebody would say it wrong. And I would always say Kevin did it wrong. Then he fucked it up.
Shout out, Kevin.
Yeah, and I was like, guys.
We love Kevin. Sorry, I aired out his dirty laundry. We were young men at the time.
And we were so rude to each other. But I love all those guys.
Yeah. Yep. I love Kevin. Shout out Kevin.
Kevin's going to brag about that for a week. He's going to be like, dude, they said I was awesome on the podcast.
Shut up.
No, I'm just kidding.
Leave Kevin alone.
No, I'm just kidding. No. But I would say something and they had to say it completely correctly.
I remember. You're looking at me telling them like, yeah, so I know.
It would be, there's a hole in my shoe. And it'd be like, what's in the hole? And then we never really got to another sentence.
No.
Because I think the other one's like, because... And then after like an hour, you guys finally got it right. You go, what's in the hole? And I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's in the hole.
It's not much of a punchline. It's just a... Well, the game.
I wanted to disappoint everybody.
These are the games we play. That's Pusha, right?
Yeah, Pusha T.
These are the names we say. Yeah, Daytona.
Broom, broom.
Can I pick my nose?
I'm in me mom's car. Broom, broom.
Yeah.
That might be the intro for this
Get out me car.
I'm in me mom's car. Broom, broom.
What do you think it was about that video that just like, I think it was just captured every...
You don't know that video?
No, what video?
The video where the British girl goes, I'm in me mom's car. Stop touching my leg. I'm in me mom's car. Broom, broom.
I've never seen that video.
This must be so weird to listen to as audio.
Yeah.
This video is a, don't touch my leg. Stop touching my leg.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Unhand me. Man.
No, but I missed that video. That was like fun times on the internet.
Yeah.
On the internet.
Very pure.
A Babylon ting.
I'm in my mom's car. Broom, broom.
Get out of my car.
Aw.
That was so in sync. What do you guys, Lance Bass and Justin Timberlake?
Five white boys, but we not in sync.
Lance Bass. What are you guys, Lance Bass? All
right. I think it's about time we wrap this one up and go hang
sorry,
out.
Sorry.
I feel good. We can just keep it going.
We have, all right, five.
We got more suck dick left.
Yeah, we only have 10 minutes left on the SD. Okay.
All right, we'll get 10 more minutes of suck dick.
We can end.
I don't want to ruin your guys' fun time.
Yeah. Come on, Chris.
I'm having fun.
Do a rap.
LA has changed you, bro.
Nah, dude.
No, but try to do a real beat. Like, try to make like a real
sick change, dude.
Oh. Damn. I told you to do a beat. You snored into the mic.
I'm fucking snoozing on the beat.
All right, I'll try real. Come on. Do a verse.
Oh, my God.
It's dude. Like you're trying to summon woodland animals.
Oh, my God.
Yo.
No. Yo, you doing what you did before.
Yo, my name is Chrissy.
Oh,
on the mic. Yeah, well, you're spitting. You're switching up the beat.
Well, that's the thing. You're supposed to acclimate to the beats.
I know, he's but right. I said one line.
He's okay. Right. You are supposed to.
Yo, my name is Chrissy. I'm here with Sean G.
Mm-hmm.
And Matt B.
Yes, we are.
On top.
Uh-huh.
I got a pod.
Yeah, we do.
Listen to it, no charge.
Mm-hmm.
All the platforms.
Yep.
Suave.
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 Suave. Suave. Suave. Suave. Suave. Suave. Suave.
Suave.
Yeah.
Yo, my name is Chrissy. I'm on the mic. Do it real quickie.
What?
Yo.
Oh my God.
Big Chris. That's word to Big Chris.
On my mama and them.
Big Chris on the beat.
Big Chrissy on the beat.
Big Chrissy on the beat.
Big Chrissy on the beat.
I'm gonna find a child and record
Big Chrissy boom and
Big
make
Chrissy
it boom.
On the beat.
Oh.
Yeah, we should do that.
Oh, did I ever tell you guys about my, speaking of it's Gay Pride Month, did I ever tell you guys about my, my Italian great uncle who's in the mafia apparently?
No, but every Italian great uncle was in the mafia apparently.
Damn.
What was his name?
I don't remember his name, but it was my dad's uncle. I don't know if that's great uncle. Is that great uncle?
Fabrizio Brambilla.
Yeah, but I remember. So apparently, what's Fabrizio?
Did I just say this one?
Yes.
My mom's friend texted me once. I don't know why. Or she messaged me on Instagram. Yeah. This was weird. She was like, if you get any messages from an account named Fabrizio Brambilla, don't listen to him. He is not real.
Don't listen to Fabrizio.
She got scammed by Fabrizio Brambilla.
What the fuck is that?
I think about it all the time.
That's a wild
poor
scam.
Lady just got messages from a guy named Fabrizio Brambilla and thought, surely this is a real person.
Oh, sounds like a Delco right?
Yeah, it's Fabrizio. Brambilla. Just like the most insane name.
There's no way.
If you receive any messages from an account named Fabrizio Brambilla.
Yo, Fabrizio Brambilla. Fabrizio Bembilla?
Brambilla. I think about Brambilla. It all the time. Anyway. Yeah.
Fabrizio.
All right. Should we call it a day on this? Sean's already nodding.
Yeah,
I'm in agreement. I guess.
Thank you guys for having me on. This is really
course.
Fun.
It was.
Yep. Thank you for coming. You need us to validate your parking?
What?
Nothing.
He's doing a goof.
Big.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. So where can the people find you? Or do they not want? Or do you not want to be found?
Why would I not want to be found, Chris?
I don't know.
Well, maybe they hate me. But if you don't hate me, it's Matt Byrne 1996 on all socials.
What does the 1996 stand for?
The year I was born, baby.
The year of our Lord.
Sean, what year were you born?
None of your fucking business,
97.
Brother.
Don't tell anybody I told you. 97. 1990s. Have you heard that song? 1997. I was
in the summer.
No, it was 1997. I was in this world flexing. You've never heard that song?
Nah.
Oh, that's a good song.
I heard 1989 number.
I don't want you guys to get copy strike.
Another summer. Get down. Sound of the funky drama.
You guys can find me at Matt Byrne, 1996, on all platforms.
Yeah, watch Matt. Go support Matt Byrne. We love Matt Byrne at the super ultimate audio visual experience.
I love you. Sorry if it started out slow.
We're so blessed to have Matt Byrne all the way from La La Land to do our humble podcast in New York City. Thank you so much, Matt. We appreciate it. I love you too. And everybody, if you want to listen to another podcast, you can go to patreon.com/tsuave.
Yeah.
With LeMay Lee.
And LeMay Lee is there.
And Noah.
And Noah's there. It was a hoot and a half.
A whole cast.
And come to the stand the first Wednesday of every month for me and Allie Mae's show, A Drip.
Ooh.
And Big Chrissy, what do you have? Do you have any shows?
No, but you could check
come
out
to the City Winery on Friday for a St. Jude's benefit show. I'll be there. LeMaire will be there.
Ooh.
It'll be fun.
Ooh.
It's in Philadelphia.
I was going to say you could check out my YouTube. It was Christian Weckesser, Weckesser.
Chrissy Wecky.
I don't know.
Chrissy?
No. I hope that you have more soon. I don't know.
We'll get you some shows, brother.
Some shows?
No, I have to pave my way. Anyway. Well,
you're on the right track, brother. Thank you all very much
for listening.
We love you very much. This has been me, Sean Gardini, my bestie, Big Cree, and Matt Byrne, signing off for this week's episode of the Super Ultimate Audiovisual Experience. Thank you for listening. God bless you
the
all.
The Super Ultimate
Audiovisual experience. Sayonara.
Bye.
So long. Thank you.
Oh, fuck. Thank you.
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 Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.